Digital evidence or digital forensics has been relied on extensively by the Narcotics Control Bureau to target several celebrities for drugs and marijuana. The reason for summoning them were old and deleted WhatsApp texts. But how reliable is this and will it hold up in court? Here's a special report.
In the Sushant Singh Rajput death investigation, the Narcotics Control Bureau summoned several persons to probe drug links to the Hindi film industry. Many were questioned on the basis of old and deleted WhatsApp chats retrieved. This brought into focus cyber forensics in today's digital age. But what exactly is digital forensics? Digital forensics is the science of getting evidence from digital media. It's the process of preservation, identification, extraction, and documentation of digital evidence which can be used in a court of law.
So the science of forensics started with this thing called Locard's principle of exchange. And Locard's principle of exchange simply says that if two things have been in contract, they leave traces of each other. This is true in the digital world also. You send around 200 parameters just by connecting to a website. And whatever activity you do, maybe it on your devices, on your desktops, on your networks, you leave traces. The internet is like a tattoo. These traces are permanent. And during investigation, be it a chat on Messenger, which is encrypted so that nobody can trace it while it is in transit. But when you get a device, you can perform forensics on that and get a lot of information which is essential for investigation. It can give you leads, it can give you locations, it can give you information about who was communicating with what was the subject of communication, what was deleted, when was it deleted. All this is a part of forensics.
Private and government agencies using third-party tools are accessing digital trails that are many years old.
Now, some of these tools are proprietary and some, while some are like, you know, freely available, that is what we call as the open source tools. For hard disk forensics, you have tools such as Autopsy, Encase, FTK. For mobile forensics, you have tools like CellBright UFED, Mobile Edit, Oxygen Forensics. Then there are special software, special tools for CCTV forensics, for network forensics, and so on. One thing I would want to add is that in using these digital forensic tools, not only we are able, the forensics experts are able to solve complex cases, but these tools are also now enabling the cybersecurity experts to harden the infrastructure and to protect their systems.
Now, two big questions. Private mobile chats, audio recordings, call details are some of the proofs that forensics experts study. But what about a citizen's right to privacy? And what kind of digital proofs stand valid in the court of law?
In cases, where there is a breach of privacy, that is a question, then in cases of law enforcement, law and order, if the government wants it or if any other party, you know, wants a particular device for an investigation, like the police force wants a device for investigation, has the rights to confiscate the same. And there would be a forensic study of the same or a digital evidence, and you know, has to be understood and analyzed. That is possible. In such a scenario, the privacy as a right will have to be superseded by the rights of law and order.
For digital records to be valid in a court of law, it's imperative that they must be certified to be authentic and that they have not been tampered, altered or manipulated in any manner whatsoever. In this regard, it's therefore essential that whenever you want to produce an electronic record or a computer output in a court of law, the same must be actually accompanied by a certificate under Section 65B of the amended Indian Evidence Act as amended by the Information Technology Act 2000.
Unlike other evidences, the intangible nature of digital evidences makes the task challenging. But for a country that reports over 44,000 cybercrime cases every year, as per NCRB's 2019 data, it is the need of the hour. In New Delhi, Arun Singh for NDTV.